नमस्ते, दिस इज़ डॉक्टर मीनाक्षी. सो आई एम विद द टॉपिक टेक्निक्स ऑफ ब्रेस्ट फीडिंग. दिस आई वॉज प्लान्ड बिफोर लास्ट वीक, दैट इज़ व्हेन वर्ल्ड ब्रेस्ट फीडिंग वीक वॉज गोइंग ऑन. ऑन दैट टाइम आई वॉज प्लान्ड टू डू दिस टॉपिक, बट ड्यू टू सम रीजन्स आई वॉज नॉट एबल टू रिकॉर्ड द वीडियो. हैज इन ब्रेस्ट फीडिंग वीक आई अपलोडेड द बेनिफिट्स ऑफ ब्रेस्ट फीडिंग. सो टुडे इज द टॉपिक इज टेक्निक्स ऑफ ब्रेस्ट फीडिंग, मीन्स वॉट इज दिस ब्रेस्ट मिल्क, मीन्स वॉट कंटेंट्स इट हैव एंड हाउ इट विल वर्क इन द ग्रोथ एंड डेवलपमेंट, वॉट ऑल चेंजेस विल बी डन एंड हाउ वी कैन फीड, द टिप्स यू कैन यूज इन ब्रेस्ट फीडिंग. इन टुडेज टॉपिक आई विल एक्सप्लेन. सो विल बिगिन द टॉपिक, दैट इज टेक्निक्स ऑफ ब्रेस्ट फीडिंग. दैट इज इन फर्स्ट टॉपिक कम्स अंडर टेक्निक्स ऑफ ब्रेस्ट फीडिंग इज वॉट इज दिस ब्रेस्ट मिल्क एंड द कंटेंट्स ऑफ ब्रेस्ट मिल्क, वॉट आर द कंटेंट्स ऑफ ब्रेस्ट मिल्क, राइट? द कंटेंट्स आर नथिंग बट यूजली इन जनरल इन कॉमनली वी नो दैट द ब्रेस्ट मिल्क कंटेंट्स ऑल न्यूट्रियंट्स विच एवर द बेबी नीड्स इन ग्रोथ एंड डेवलपमेंट, वन थिंग. And the main content is the breast milk contains lysozymes, that is the lysozyme factor, which it is an enzyme which fight against the E. coli. The baby will be protected with E. coli and Salmonella, and it have the action of anti-inflammatory functions. These all will be part of lysosomes enzyme which is present in breast milk. And another thing is bifidus factor. This bifidus factor helps in the growth of lactobacillus which protects the baby from hormonal bacteria. This bifidus is a factor which will be helpful in growth of lactobacillus. It will protect the baby from bacterial infections. So, and also this breast milk includes many types of antibodies which can be helpful in fight against the infections, like IgG, IgM, all will be present in breast milk, antibodies that will fight against the infections. So they will give the immunity power for the baby. So, and the main thing is first 7 days this breast milk contains colostrum. That colostrum will act as a first shot of vaccine for a baby. If the baby have this colostrum immediately after delivery within 30 to 60 minutes, then the baby will be having much power of immunity. The immune system of a baby will be strong. So the next coming is, now we came to know what are the contents present in breast milk, right? And the next is when we should start breastfeeding. Next question will be, that is immediately after delivery within 60 to 30 minutes, within half an hour or within 1 hour, you should start feeding so that the baby will get, as I explained, first shot of colostrum as a vaccine. And when baby will get skin to skin touch, the emotional bondings with the mother will be strong, and you can examine the rooting and sucking reflex of a baby immediately after birth, whether it is good or bad. And due to sucking stimulation, there will be stimulation for the secretion of breast milk. So these all will be benefited if you feed a baby within 30 minutes to 60 minutes. After delivery, within 30 or 60 minutes, you should start feeding a baby. But in such conditions, like if baby is ill or baby have any health issues, he is in NICU or she is in NICU, intensive care unit, then in such conditions, it will be inevitable. We can go for other options. Next point is contraindications, means in which conditions you should not feed a baby. In any condition you should not stop, in any condition of ill health of a baby also you should not stop breastfeeding. though the baby is ill health and he is admitted or she is admitted in a NICU, intensive care unit, you should feed a baby at least through the expressed breast milk. You should feed a baby, you should not stop. But some particular points are there in which if mother is active TB patient or untreated TB patient, and if mother is taking the radiotherapy or chemotherapy for the treatment of cancer, and in such conditions like the mother is taking illegal drugs in some inevitable conditions, if the mother is taking some illegal drugs which are contraindicated for breastfeeding, and the mother who is HIV infected, only in these conditions the baby should be stopped by breastfeeding. Rather than this, all other conditions, though the baby is in ill health condition also, you should give breast milk. Breast milk is the nectar for a baby. By comparing the breast milk, no any other food or diet or any other medicines can't beat the factors of breast milk. So in any condition you should not stop breast milk, except some 2 to 3 conditions of a mother. And next thing comes is, you came to know when you should start breastfeeding, when you should stop breastfeeding. Now you started a breastfeed, but you should know how the latching of a baby should be, how the baby should be fed, and in which position the baby should be fed, right? First point is latching of a baby, how the baby should latch a nipple. Some parents, what they will do, some mothers, they will give a nipple to a baby's mouth and they will sit blindly, whether they will not be knowing that baby is sucking, especially first time mother, they will not be knowing what are the points to be noted while feeding, right? The baby should open wide, the baby's mouth should be wide opened, and he should take a full part of a nipple till areola in a mouth, so that the whole nipple will be in mouth to suck easily. And you should keep a baby in a slight upward position so that the baby can swallow the milk easily, and the breast should look round and filled. And the next point is, you can hear a sound which the baby is sucking and swallowing. You should hear calmly, you should hear a sound of a baby, so that you can guess that baby is taking a feed. And after feeding, after completion of feed, your nipple will look straight, long and elevated, so that it is a sign that baby took a feed completely and satisfactorily. So next point comes is techniques. Means now you came to know how the baby we should take a nipple in a mouth, but the positions, technique means nothing but positions, in which all positions you can feed. The if the technique word comes, only one main point you should keep in mind, that you should keep a baby bit straight so that the baby can swallow the airway line will be cleared to swallow a breast milk. One thing, not only in breast milk, whatever you feed after 6 months, if you start weaning also, you should slightly make the upward for the baby, because in fully slant position baby can't swallow easily, right? The airway will be blocked, the root of a swallowing part will be blocked. So you should make this baby to slightly upward, and you can use your arms, forearms, to support a baby's neck, so that the baby's neck head will be in slight upward position. And this is the main point you should remember while feeding. And another point is, the baby and mother should be closely lied or in a sitting position. They should be skin to skin touch, so that the baby will be bonding will be good, and the baby's temperature will be protected by skin to skin touch. You may be heard in preterm babies, Kangaroo method. Kangaroo method is specially for the skin to skin touch, so that the there will be the temperature maintenance of a baby, right? So here skin to skin touch, close touch should be, and the position should be in right manner, that is slightly upwards. And coming for the techniques, that is positions, many positions are there, that baby standing, baby sitting, and out of hand, or if there are twins, both breast with for a twins you can give one, or lying on a pillow, or a cradle position, and side lying position. Many positions are there, but in these some four positions are very commonly used and right way. Those are those four points are cradle hold, cross cradle hold. Cradle means like swing, right? We will take a baby in a cradle form and we will feed. That is one right correct manner. Side cradle manner, that is also you can go for. Or football position, like holding a baby's head, you can feed. Or side lying position, again side lying position also you can feed, but you should remember the position of a head of a baby. If you make the baby fully lying and you should if you give a feed, again there will be blockage in a swallowing also, and there may be chances of ear infection. So if you are feeding a baby in lying position, then remember to give a pillow support or your arm support to slightly upward a baby's head. These are the positions of the baby. Next, coming for the point, how long you should feed, for time duration, right? Normally in newborns you should feed for every 2 to 3 hours, and the duration should be 5 to 10 minutes. Here main point is it goes on demand of a baby, but for a knowledge, in newborns you should feed 5 to 10 minutes for every 2 to 3 hours, so that there will be feed 10 to 12 times a day, because baby will be exclusively on breast milk till 6 months, and has till 1 month the baby for 7 days the milk will be fully colostrum, so it will be heavy. Later after 1 month the baby can feed, the duration may change within 1 hour or within 1.5 hours, it may change. You should be prepared for that. And 1 month and above, after 1 month 20 to 40 minutes breastfeed the baby can take, that too for 3 to 4 hours duration. And after 6 months, as you start weaning, then the automatically breast milk duration will be decreased, that is 20 to 40 minutes per feed, and 3 to 5 hours for every 3 to 5 hours, because in middle you will be weaning something, supplementary foods, right? So these all just for your knowledge, but as the baby feed depends on the baby's demand, exclusively demand. But till 3 months, from newborn baby to 3 months, you should feed every 2 to 3 hours for every episode 5 to 10 minutes you should feed. After 3 months it depends on the baby's demand. So next point is what are the signs that we can know that baby is getting sufficient breast milk, right? So first point is, after feed the baby can sleep coolly, aram se, without disturb 1 to 2 hours, and baby should pass a urine 8 to 12 times per day in 24 hours, and baby will pass a stool, yellow color watery stool, 6 to 7 times in 24 hours. And especially from birthday till 7 days the baby will decrease its weight. After 7 days again it starts to gain a weight. After completion of 2 weeks, that is in 1 week, the baby will reach his or her birth weight. That's the main sign that baby is getting a sufficient breast milk. If these 3 to 4 points are present in a baby, then no need to worry, your baby is getting sufficient breast milk. though these 3 to 4 points are fulfilled, then also baby is crying frequently or baby is disturbed, then see for other reasons like comfortable of a baby's bed maybe, or maybe baby is getting colic pain, something else, something other health issues. If these 4 to 5 points are present after feeding or in a baby, then there is no doubt baby is getting sufficient breast milk. After all this, the another main point in breastfeeding techniques is burping. You all may be knowing what is burping, right? Burping means after feed immediately you should not make baby to sleep. Though the baby is sleeping, you should take a baby on your shoulder and you should tap. You should not hit the baby, just tap or slightly rub the baby's back so that the baby will regurgitate, or the baby will give the fulfillment burping sound of a feed. So that why we should do this is, after while feeding, while swallowing, baby will swallow the air with the milk, so that the air will be swallowed, and if you didn't burp, the baby will regurgitate all the milk which is fed. So you should make a burping at least for 5 minutes. So within 5 minutes, baby will take a burping sound, so that you can make a baby to sleep. You can make burping on a shoulder or on a sitting position. If baby is sleeping, then you can take on a shoulder and you can rub slightly, or you can make a baby to sit on your lap and slightly rub a back, or slightly tap on the margin of a diaper, so that the baby will take a burping sound. Or else usually mothers will complain, after feed my baby will vomit everything whichever feeded, or the baby will vomit like curdy. Also if all completing of burping also the baby is taking vomiting or regurgitating the feeded milk, then it depends on the diet of a mother. If you are taking a lot of sour diet or lot of spicy diet, in such conditions also baby may vomit the feeded milk. Or else you can feed after immediately feeding, you can make a burping so that baby will not vomit the feeded milk. So this was the topic of breast milk and the techniques of breast milk, how you should feed and the ways of positions of the feeding. So hope you all are getting the knowledge or getting help of my videos. Thank you.